I remember you saying that the Tree of Life doesn't exist anymore. What exactly happened to it?
It was destroyed during the Deluge.
Deluge?
When Jehovah flooded the entire Earth, only one family survived.
That seems extreme. Why would he do that?
Extreme times call for extreme measures. If you knew how bad it was, then you wouldn't ask why he did it, but why he didn't do it sooner. People multiplied greatly in the Earth, and they built great cities. And because people lived a lot longer back then, some over 900 years, it didn't take long for the Earth to be filled with people.
900 years?
Yes. So it's quite possible that there were just as many people at the time of the Flood as there is today.
Did they have advanced technology or something to prolong their life?
Cleaner and better air, better genetics, better food. And yes, technology also advanced quickly. Tubal-Cain is mentioned in the biblical account as being an expert blacksmith. Within only 7 generations, man jumped from the Stone Age to the Iron Age.
This is a far different picture of the ancient past than the version I was taught in school.
If the masses knew the real history of the world, maybe they'd be less likely to repeat the same mistakes. And if the deluge was real, then the devil's narrative of millions of years falls apart. On the surface, it would seem like it was a golden age for humanity, but the reality was that those days were incredibly evil.
Fire.
Murder was being unpunished and even celebrated.
I have killed a man for wounding me, a young man for striking me.
Violence, war, and famine ravaged the globe. Injustice everywhere, and people yearned desperately for a hero. And to prevent the world from turning back to the Almighty as their savior, the devil came up with an insidious plan, and he convinced many of the angels to join him in his rebellion against God.
Come, let us mingle with the humans. If they want a hero, then we'll give them a hero. We will take some of the finest women specimens and experiment on them, and build a master race, and their desire for a hero will be their undoing.
And so some of the devil's angels took wives of any of the women they chose and bore children by them.
Whoa, this is insane.
Yes, it is. I know it sounds freakish, but it's the truth.
And you said they took wives, not slaves? The women went along with this?
Most likely, they were already involved in witchcraft, and would have felt it was an honor to be a part of Satan's treacherous breeding program. The devil may have promised them power.
Sounds like a plotline of a horror flick.
Yes, and such horror produced. The women gave birth to giants, very tall individuals with supernatural abilities. They were the, quote, heroes of old, men of renown. The Nephilim, they were greatly feared and worshipped. And though the masses saw them as great heroes, they were violent, ruthless, heartless monsters. In some legends, they were described as vampires and cannibals.
Yikes. Why would anyone worship these guys?
Because that was the version of a hero that the masses wanted. They wanted someone violent to overthrow their oppressors, a military leader who would liberate them from all their bondage, not understanding that the real bondage was their rebellion against God, and that they needed to be delivered, but quickly forgot God and the promise of the coming Redeemer, and accepted the imposters instead, and were eternally damned. And if God did not intervene, the entire human race would have ceased to exist.
Whoa, that sure changes my perspective on his wrath.
Same here.